Hello friends, welcome to Dev's Institute. Today we'll see one more assignment from Processor Architecture subject, that is implementing C program using DOS interrupt function. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking subscribe button given below the video and click on bell icon to get instant notification about the videos. So this is the problem statement for the program. Write menu driven program in C using int86, int86x, intdos, intdosx functions for implementing following operations: to delete file, to create directory, to delete directory, to create file. So we have to implement these four functions: to delete file, create directory, delete directory and create file, using these four functions, that is int86, int86x, intdos and intdosx. These four functions are available in the header file dos.h. So before going towards directly program or these functions, first we'll see what structures and unions are present in dos.h file which will be required to execute or to call or to use these functions. So dos.h file contains one structure called as word regs. Okay, so we all know that in 8086 there are registers A, B, C, D, SI, DI. Okay, all these registers AX, BX, CX, DX, all registers are of 16 bits. Okay, so this word regs is the structure which contains the value of all registers AX, BX, CX, DX. Along with this, it has two index registers SI, DI and then one C flag, that is carry flag, and PSW is nothing but program status word, that is nothing but the flag register. So this is all about word register. So as name suggests, word means it is 16 bit. Okay, AX is a 16 bit register. That's why we have used unsigned integer. Means here in this dos.h structure word regs contains the values which are unsigned integer, that means 16 bit long. Next, in dos.h we have another structure named byte regs. Okay, so AX register is divided into two 8 bit registers AL and AH. Okay, so this AL, AH, BL, BH are, or these values are present, or you can access these values by using this structure byte regs. Okay, so word regs is a structure available in dos.h. This is everything available in dos.h. We are now studying what is present in dos.h file. Okay, so it contains word regs struct which contains the place to hold all 16 bit values of the register. Next, it contains structure byte regs which are nothing but the 8 bit registers AL, AH, BL, BH, CL, CH, DL, DH. Okay, then next, dos.h contain one union which is regs which contains one object of this structure word regs and another object of this structure byte regs. So union regs is a union of word regs and byte regs. So struct word regs x. Now the object of this word regs is x and object of byte regs is h. So these two objects we need to remember, because we are going to create an object of union regs, and if we want to access the word register, that is AX, BX, 16 bit register, if we want to access, in that case we have to access it through this object X, because X is the object of word register structure. And if we want to access 8 bit register, that is AL, AH, in that case we have to access these registers using this object H. So this X and H, these two objects we need to remember. For word regs it is X, and for byte regs it is H. Lastly, we have another structure called as SREGS, and it contains all segment registers ES, CS, DS and SS. So in all in DOS, there are many more structures and unions are available in DOS.h, but right now we are only focusing on the structures and union which will be required for our program. Okay, so for more details you can visit the man page of this DOS.h file. So in short, it contains one structure word regs, another structure byte regs, a union of these two structures, and the structure for segment registers, that is SREGS. Next, it contains two macros to split the long pointer into the offset and segment part. So first macro is FP off pointer. So here if we provide the address, it will give you the offset point, offset part of that address, because we know that every address in microprocessor consists of segment, base address and offset. So here if we give the address, okay, which we will see this in detail at the time of implementing it in program, but just now for simplicity, consider that if we give any pointer, means if we give address here, it will give you, or this FP underscore of macro will return you the offset part of that address, and FP underscore seg, this macro will return you the segment base address from that entire address. So this FP of and FP seg are basically used to split long pointer into the offset and the segment part. Then next is we have four functions, and those, by using those four functions, we have to implement the said functionalities, that is create a directory, delete a directory, create a file and delete a file. Okay, so first function is intdos, and its return type is integer. Okay, this function uses two arguments. First one is union regs pointer, and second one is union regs pointer. So we have already seen in previous slide, this union regs contains the object of two structures, word regs and byte regs, and object of this union regs we have to pass as a argument to intdos. So what is this union or what is this regs object and what is this regs object? This regs object represents the regs value, that is register values, when passed to the function. So when we have to call this intdos function, so we have to set some values in the register in order to execute the function. Okay, so when DOS interrupt, we all are aware that when DOS interrupt is executed, we generally we use INT21H instruction in assembly language program. INT21H instruction, what it does, it It looks for the function code stored in AH and it works accordingly. So similarly, if you want to execute a create directory function, or if you want to execute a delete directory function, then in that case, you have to pass a specific value, or you have to set the specific value to the AH register. So likewise, the register values required to execute the specific function will be provided through this union. When the function is executed, then there may be change in the register values, and that change in the register value will get through this second object, that is union regs pointer. Again, here we are providing address of the union regs object, and here again we are providing one regs object pointer. Okay, just now remember its syntax. The function name is intdos. It is going to return integer. First argument is pointer to object of union of type union regs, pointer to object of type union regs. Okay, at the time of program I will explain it in again detail. Then next function is intdosx. Now intdos and intdosx are almost the same, only intdosx requires one more argument, that is a pointer to object struct sregs. Now sregs is a structure which contains the segment registers. So intdos and intdosx, only one difference, that is the third argument is struct sregs. Then we have one more function, int86. Now here intdos means it is for DOS interrupts, that is interrupt number 21H. Now here it is int86 is used, can be used for any of the interrupt. Okay, so here first argument is the number of the interrupt to be executed, interrupt number, and then two arguments, next two arguments will be same as that of intdos. So union regs pointer, in union regs, in register and out register. Next is int86x. Again, it is the interrupt 86. So again, we have to first provide the interrupt number to be executed, then in register, out registers, and then the pointer to sregs. Okay, so these four functions are almost similar. Intdos, here we are specifying that it is a DOS interrupt, so no need to provide the interrupt number, only we will provide the in register pointer and out register pointer. Similarly, here we'll provide in register, out register, along with it segment registers. Structure pointer to structure of segment registers. Int 86 means interrupt of 86. So here you have to provide the interrupt number. Now we are dealing with interrupt number 21, that is DOS interrupt in this function. So it will be, this integer value will be 0x21, that is 21H. Okay. And this will be the register pointers. Similarly, here only we are going to provide the fourth argument, that is sregs, pointer to struct sregs. So this is all about DOS.h. Okay. Now we'll see the program, actual program. Before going to the actual program, just remember this thing. We have this union regs, in that we have word regs and byte regs. Word regs object is x and byte regs object is h. Okay, so now we'll move towards program. So this is a program. This is C program. Okay, so dot, this is dot C file. first two statements hash include stdio.h, hash include dos.h. Now the structure, union, different functions we have just discussed, those are present in dos.h and we are going to use those, so that's why we have to include dos.h file. Now this program contains four functions. First one is create directory, next is delete directory, create file, and then next is the delete file, and last one is the main function, because we have to execute the menu driven program. So main function where you are going to actually ask for the menu. Okay, then first we'll see the specific function. First function is create directory, so we are going to call this create directory function from the main function, and obviously we'll use for the directory name, okay, that is location of the directory from the user. So here in this main function, user will provide the directory. Suppose user enters 1, that is create directory. User will enter directory name and will call function create directory and will pass the directory name. So function control will be transferred here. So now we have called create directory function and we have passed the directory name to the function. So inside function, what we have did, we have created one object of union regs. Okay, so now we know that this is our union regs, which is present in dos.h. We have created one object of this union regs, that is regs. Okay, we have created one object of this structure, struct regs, struct as sregs, sregs. Okay, then we have define two integer values, return and error, which will be required to get the return status of the function. Simple. Okay, now see, to execute create a directory, okay, we are aware that for DOS interrupt number is 21H. So when DOS interrupt is executed, it will check the function number present in AH register and it will work accordingly. Okay, so if you want to create a directory, you need to provide function number of create a directory into AH register. Okay, so now AH register is present in byte register. Object of byte register is H. This byte register is present in union regs, and union object of union regs is regs. That's why regs, which is union regs object, regs dot h dot ah. So object of this union regs, regs dot h dot ah, will give you the access or will give you the location of ah register. And simply whatever we are going to write here, that will be stored in AH register. Okay, so 0x39, that means 39H will be stored in AH register. Okay, next is we have to separate out the segment base address, and that is the directory name is provided. So by providing that directory name to the macro fpof and fpseg, which we have seen here, fpof and fpseg. Okay, so we'll provide directory name to fpof, will give us the offset address, and that offset address we are going to store in dx register. Okay, and fpseg directory name, we are passing directory name again, it will return you the segment base address and that will be stored in DS register. Now what is job of 39H? Job of 39H is to create a directory, okay, create a directory whose location or at the location which is given in DX register, Okay, and base address or the base segment base address will be stored in DS register. Directory will be created at the address which is stored in DX register by considering base address of the segment stored in DS register. Okay, so first we have set AH value to 39H, then we have stored offset address into DX, then we have stored segment base address into DS, and then we'll call the function. Means we have initialized all the registers with the required data. AH will contain 39H, DX will contain offset address of the directory where the directory is to be created, and DS will contain the base address of the segment. Okay. Next we'll call this intdos function. So intdos function, we know that intdos function uses only two arguments, union regs, in regs and out regs. So here our in regs and out regs we are passing are same, so the register changes will be made in the same union object. So and regs and regs, so this will execute the interrupt. So now this intdos means DOS interrupt. It will look for the function code stored in AH. AH contain 39H. So meaning of 39H is create a directory at a location which is whose address is present in DX register, and base address will be considered as data segment's base address of the segment. Okay, so the directory will be created. So based on this, the directory will be either created or not created. It will be created, but if there is error, it will not be created. So whatever is the return status, that will be written, because the return value of this is return status is integer. So that will be created, that will be written, and we are collecting that return value in RET. Okay, so now how to check whether it is error or not? If it is error, your carry flag will be set. So now C flag is present in word regs and object is x. So union regs object regs dot x dot C flag. So union regs object regs dot x dot C flag. If this is set, error will be equal to RET, else it will be 0. Means it is no error. So if error, then only carry flag will be set. If no error, carry flag will not be set. So this statement will set the return value to the error number. Okay, so we'll check if not error, means if it is 0, then directory created successfully. If error is equal to 5, directory already created or directory already exists. So we cannot create a directory with the same name, or else directory means there is some another error than directory already exists, that is directory not created. So this is all about the create directory function. Now next is the delete directory. Same for delete directory, we have to provide the directory name. Again, union regs object of union regs will be created, struct regs will be created. Now here to delete directory, again the function name is 3a. Okay, so ah will be assigned the value 3a. Again we are storing offset address into DS and segment base address into DS. Okay, and the function will be called. Here just for sake of understanding, we are using intdosx. So here it will be three arguments, and regs and sregs, which is nothing but a object for segment register, struct SREGS. Okay. Again, similarly, the return value will be created, carry flag will be checked. If carry flag is set, then return means it is error, and error number will be assigned to the return value will be assigned to error. So if not error, directory deleted successfully. If there is error number 6, directory already deleted means directory doesn't exist, and else directory could not be deleted. Similarly, we have create file. For create file, function number is 5b. Okay, here only we have used int 86 function. So in int 86, the first number or the first argument which we need to provide is the interrupt number, right? Here the first argument we need to provide is the interrupt number. So here interrupt number is 21H, REGS, REGS. And similarly, in last program, in last function, for a delete file, function code is 41H and we have used int 86X, 21H and REGS and REGS and SREGS. Okay, so some error numbers are considered while writing the program, and this is simply the main function. We have used switch case to switch to a particular case. So this is all about the DOS interrupt, means using DOS interrupt functions to create file, delete directory, and create a directory and delete a file. Delete a directory and create a file. Okay. I hope you have understood the concept. If you have any doubts, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you very much.